Go for it.
It went through it.
Story of my freaking life!
Today we're going to explore using powder-actuated tool ammo in firearms. These are 22 cartridges that are necked down and crimped. Now these are head-stamped Super X, so they're obviously made by Winchester. It is clearly marked on the box not to use these in a firearm. So let's see what happens when we do.
Para el dos calibres del 22. Pa todo número 4.
I think he's saying, damn, it's cool to be out here with TAOFLEDERMAUS.
That's what I said.
So what's your idea here?
You stick the pellet in here.
And what are we using to power the pellets?
These little...
And those are
hammer
for
rounds or
the nail guns or those concrete setters, powder charged, and you can get those at Lowe's. There's no shortage of those things. How much are those for a box?
Like $4.
$4 or $5.
Yeah, $4 or $5.
And we're shooting pellets, 22 pellets, out of a old beater 22 here, this Remington Speedmaster. We want to find out if this is a good idea, a terrible idea, or a great idea. It could be unsafe.
I think it's great.
We'll see. So we're kind of muzzling, you know, it is, you made sure it was clear, right?
Yes.
Oh, you know, we never put the charge in first. We put the pellet in first.
And we know right where to stop.
About another half inch down. There you go. Got it marked. And it's a slow, tedious process to do this. And then when you just throw up, that's the most powerful one they had at Lowe's. And then you can just charge it, and then we'll see how well it works. See it in there? There you go. Go for it. Wow.
It went through it.
Now it went through this plate. How thick is that? That's pretty thick. About 1/8 inch stainless steel plate. And that, you think a normal 22 will do that? I think we need to try that. Okay, normal 22, how will it fare against our stainless plate? Whenever you're ready. Okay, that's the 14 grain pellet. And that's a, what is that, 38 grain?
Yeah.
22. Pellet went through there like butter. That's the backside, just nothing but dust. Wow. Okay, let's shoot the book. It's about 1.5 inches thick. Whenever you're ready, go. I thought, you know, shooting those pellets with a, you know, cement powder charge would be a stupid idea, but they work pretty good. And you can see it made a very clean hole. It wasn't tumbling or anything. We were concerned that maybe the pellets might not be able to handle that kind of velocity tumble around, but they're flying pretty true. Okay, at normal 22, let's see how the book holds up to that. Whenever you're ready.
Neither the pellet nor the mini mag made it all the way through that book. We couldn't find any big remnants of the pellet, and this is what we found from the 22 mini mag.
Okay, we're going to shoot the locker. We've shot a bunch of times before. Let's see how these pellets do that. It's pretty thick metal. Okay, hit it. Okay, let's shoot a normal 22 at the locker door, see how it compares. Anytime. Way different. So a normal 22 will go through there. Not a very, I mean, look how clean that is. It didn't even dent it. Normal 22, no problem going through that.
Look at the back. Way different.
Yeah, pellet, 22. Looks, I mean, it looks like it almost drilled through that thing with a laser. See how it does against one of these ditch bank watermelons, because that's all we can afford.
Pieces.
What are you going to say now?
Whoever's trying to make these rounds, this is what they want. If you're shooting a squirrel, it's not going through it.
Wow.
Exploded it.
That is one ugly watermelon.
It's funny, they don't look like regular watermelons at all, do they?
What about, we gotta compare with a regular 22 too. Okay, normal hollow point 22 long rifle against the same, quote, watermelon. Hit it. I don't know if these are even watermelon. You found these, right?
Yeah.
Ditch bank. Went through there. The pellet, I'd say one.
Yeah.
What about shooting it out of a pistol?
Yeah, we could try that.
Okay. Okay, now these things are probably a bad idea to shoot out of a gun, but they're working. And they actually eject out the empty brass and everything. You gotta put a piece of tape on there and know where to stop it, but always load the round in first and then load the powder charge in there. Okay, out of a Ruger pistol.
I would say the damage from the pellets is comparable to a high velocity varmint round. The Crosman hollow point pellets were obviously engaging the rifling and causing them to spin and fly stably and accurately. Neither these powder charges nor these pellets were ever designed to be shot out of a firearm. They may be small, but they pack a hell of a punch. These next few clips, I put the pellet shots on the top, the CCI mini mag shots on the bottom, so we can compare the speeds. The CCI mini mag was clearly outpaced by the 14 grain pellet. The mini mag was only about a third of the way there. If I were to guess, the pellets were traveling in excess of 2,500 feet per second. The damage between the two rounds was clearly different in each shot. The high velocity pellets dumped all their energy into the watermelons instead of passing right through it. I paid $10 for 500 rounds of these Crosman hollow point 22s, and these powder chargers were about $5 for 100 rounds. So for about $35, you get 500 rounds.